Coming in at number four, the Amarillo mayoral election recount. The recount came at the request of candidate Claudette Smith, who claimed thousands contacted her with concerns over the integrity of the election. Teams counted all of the ballots by hand on May 12th. The city found a net change of 10 votes during that process, but that didn't change the outcome of the election. The recount cost Smith and the city nearly $6,000 apiece. Incumbent Mayor Ginger Nelson was sworn into office on May 25th. The city officials say the recount was the first official recount they're aware of in recent city history. Number three, the latest on the Thomas Brown case. It was perhaps the most in-depth look into Brown's case that we've seen. In October, the Texas Attorney General's office released an investigation summary on Brown's case. The AG's office noted in its introduction to the published report that, quote, "This investigation has reached an impasse and should be suspended until such time as additional reliable evidence may be discovered," end quote. That report came in addition to a presentation by Klein Investigations and Consulting, a private investigation group hired by Brown's family. Klein proposed his version of the case's timeline and information, but there were notable inconsistencies with the Attorney General's report. Number two, the historic winter storm. February saw a Texas-sized winter storm sweep across the Lone Star State. The storm left so many across the state without power as temperatures reached the single digits. Texas's electric grid became the focal point after days of the dangerous temperatures left millions of Texans in the dark. Many in the panhandle were spared from the long-term effects of the storm thanks to being on a separate power grid from the rest of the state, but we still had to do our part to keep the grid intact, including controlled rolling blackouts and schools canceling classes to help conserve energy. Number one, the coronavirus on the High Plains. The first of the year started off with hope in the battle against COVID-19 as more and more people were able to get vaccinated against the virus. The Amarillo metro area led the nation in vaccination rates. According to COVIDActNow.gov, more than 10% of the metro area having their first shot by the end of January. As the year progressed, hospitalizations and active cases seemed to be on a downward trend, but by midsummer, the Delta variant became a new concern and case numbers once again on the uptick. This time last year, more than 900 people on the High Plains had died from the virus. That number now more than doubled. The Delta variant still dominating our area as the new Omicron variant making its way through the country. Health experts still say vaccination is the best defense against the disease. Judd Baker, KAMR Local 4 News.